everyone, welcome back to Business Studies class. In last class, we have seen the different dimensions of business, that is like economic environment, meaning we have seen, and different examples are the factors which are involved in that particular environment. What all the factors we count as a particular environment, we have seen in last class, isn't it? Okay. And even I told you that we'll be concentrating mainly on economic environment of a business in this chapter. So we are going with that. Now we have economic environment in general. It might be in any country, how an economic development will be, economic environment will be to a business. Or else even you can think in this way, what are the forces of economic environment which will be forcing a business, which are influencing the business? That's we are going to see in this particular topic. Okay, this we are going to study in macro level, means the all the six factors what you have, they are in macro level. Okay, that is they are in large scale. Good. So we have 6 points which will generally comes under economic environment, which will be influencing business in any country. Okay, the first one is stages of economic development. Second, the economic structure of the country. The third one, economic policies of the government. Next, economic planning of the country. Then comes economic indicators or indices. Then comes infrastructural factors. All these 6 factors considered as economic environment of any country and which will be having influence of business in any country. Clear? All right. So the first one is stages of economic development. So an economist called Rostow, he has given some 5 stages of economic development of a country, in any country in general. Okay, it will be like this. Traditional society, that is the initial stages of the society. You might be remember what was the initial stage of business in our country. As we know, barter system was were there, that is goods were exchanged with the goods only. We don't have an introduction of money at the initial stages of business, isn't it? And how the countries has come into selling activity through we know that spices were produced more, that is the agriculture, right? So through that, many eastern countries, they have entered into our country. This was the initial stage of our business, isn't it? In similar way, if you take any country, there will be generally 5 stages of economic development as per Rostow. He has given, the first one is traditional society, and second one is preconditions for takeoff. Conditions for takeoff in the sense, that is the pre, in the sense almost near to those conditions where there was population explosion. Okay, started population explosion, started even business, there's just starting for enlargement. So all those conditions he has termed as preconditions for takeoff. That is the second stage. And the third one is takeoff. This is a situation where the investment started, different people has started investing in the industry, in the different fields of an economic development of the country. That is takeoff stage. Then comes drive to maturity, and then the country is moved for the maturity levels, that is technological era we call. That is there is introduction of technology, and even many people acquired this technology for using there. It might be for agriculture or for business, anything else. That we called as drive to maturity. And the last stage is age of mass consumption. So when you say economic stages of economic development, generally these 5 stages will be there as per Rostow. Right, so the first one, you just try to remember these 5 stages. We don't have any detailed study for this as per your class. Okay, just for headings, you please remember these 5 stages of economic development. Even in your notes, it might be given: traditional society, preconditions for takeoff, takeoff, drive to maturity, and mass consumption. These are the 5 stages in economic development of any country in general. Right, so this will affect the business. So if you are in first stage, the effect will be less. If you are in the second stage, the effect will be bit more. It will be like that. So depending upon the stage of economic development, see, we are in developing countries list, right? But many of the countries, they are still in underdeveloped countries list. So we have to assume, if you want to start a business there, you have to analyze and see in which economic stage of development they are. Okay, so in order to know all these things, these five steps, five different conditions or stages of economic development, you should just remember. First one is traditional society, preconditions for the takeoff, drive to maturity, and age of mass consumption. Then comes economic structure of a country. Economic structure of a country, how it is, like how the plans are developed, right? How the system is existing, or how, what are the different plans to develop the economy, okay? What is the structure they have made, okay? That is very essential to know in order to see what type of effect it will, what type of impact it will be there on the business. Then come economic policies of the government in general, like industrial policy, like 5-year plans, all these things are budgets. All these things we should have an idea in order to know how it will have an impact on business. Then comes your economic indicators. Economic planning of the country. Economic planning of the country in the sense like annual reports, 5-year plan, government decisions regarding the business, budgets, what they allow to the business. All these things has to be analyzed and to see how it will be having impact on our business. Then is your economic indices or indicators, as we know, like a GDP. To know the economic condition of a country, we generally see the GDP, that is gross domestic product. The rate of GDP will be seen, even just like GNP. And then even we'll be going with the stock exchange indicators like BSE, NSE will be referring. All these things are just, we say these are the barometers to study the country's economic situation, right? Even this will be helpful to know the economic environment and how it will be having impact on the business. And lastly, infrastructure facilities, like how the transportation in your country, what is the financial institution setup. I mean, you know, financial institutions we have seen in our first year business studies. Different financial institutions will be set up in order to support the business. So in some countries, such a financial institutions will not be set up. So business will not have enough funds. Are you getting that? All right. So even communication, what are the different communication systems you have in your country and how it will be, because we know that communication is very essential for our business, because we have even this part we have seen in business services, postal services and communication services we have seen, isn't it? So whether all these things, how they are in your particular country, will be studying in our economic environment. So all this, even transportation facility also we can see in infrastructure facility. Okay, factors. So all these 6 points will help us to know the economic environment of a particular business, right? So after knowing all these things, after studying and analyzing all these things, we can start studying how it will be having impact. So as we know that business environment importance we have seen, by studying the economic environment of any country, what for a particular business, we'll be coming out with the opportunities, or we'll be getting signals or warnings for the threats, and even it will be helping to cope up with the changes, isn't it? So rapid change can be possible by knowing and having awareness about all these things. Okay, so it might be asked for 4 marks and stages of economic development for 2 marks, so that you have to remember. Next we have as economic environment in India at the time of independence. So as I said, we'll be concentrating on economic environment. So here you have how the economic environment of India was at the time of independence. So accordingly, it has an effect on business. All right. So you can see these points. Indian economy was based on what? Generally, agriculture. At the time of independence, Indian economy, that is the money system, the system of raising money was completely, or most of it, it was dependent on what? Agriculture. Then 70% of working population, they engaged in agriculture. About 85% of population lived in villages. And then production was carried out in irrational manner. There is no rationality, that is no similarity, and with low productive techniques. You know, when we go with low productive techniques, the cost of the production increases and ultimately the prices increases. And there was no good public health system, that is communicable diseases where their mortality rate was high at the time of independence. So this was the economic environment of India at the time of independence. Is it clear? So these 5 points, again, it can be asked for 4 marks. It's simple. Simple to understand. That is, we are seeing the history, how India was, how economic environment of India was at the time of independence. So it has a significant effect on what? Industry, that is business. Once again, I'll read it out. The Indian economy was almost based on what? Agriculture. Okay, so the income for the government was from agriculture itself, right? Because of low industrialization. Then most of the working population, they were engaged in agriculture itself. And 85% of population lived in villages. Okay, then production was carried out on irrational basis and with low productive techniques. And communicable diseases were high, mortality rate were high. So this is the economic environment of India at the time of independence. By having such a situation, in the year 1991, government has come out with a new industrial policy. So as we know, we have understood in first year syllabus itself, in order to move or in order to develop, in order to give more employment opportunities, industrialization is must. That is, there should be more scope for industries. So with that intention, government has come out with a new industrial policy, that is in the year 1991. This is one of the most important industrial policy we have to ever remember. That is new industrial policy of 1991. There they have given more preference to the LPG. You might be knowing this because you might studied this in your economic subject. So L stands for liberalization, P stands for privatization, and G stands for globalization. So in new industrial policy of 1991, they have given more preference to what? LPG, that is towards the business. Okay, the features of 1991 policy, they are like this, and this can be asked for again 4 marks. You should be careful. Reduced the number of industries under the compulsory licensing. So earlier, before this act, many industries have to take licensing, that is compulsory licensing. Without they take, if they don't have license, they cannot start the industry. So what happened? Because of such restrictions, many, they didn't come forward to start an industry. By observing this, through 1991 policy, new industrial policy, government has reduced the number of industries which has to be started under licensing. As you know, nowadays only for few business we need particular license. For other types of business, there is no need of taking any license from the government. Then just said only we have license list of the type of industry. Only if you fall under that, you have to take license. If not, you can start an industry. That happened only because of your new policy of 1990. The second one is reduced the industries under public sector. So earlier it was a situation that a few types of industries has to be run, started by the government itself, that is by the public sector. When I say public sector, it might be a government company, it might be a statutory company, or it might be a departmental undertaking. So a few particular, for example, railways, it's a type of business which has to be carried on only by the public sector. Okay, as a departmental undertaking. And even you might be knowing LIC, that is life insurance company. Earlier, life insurance, I mean insurance company, has to be carried on only by the government. But with the new industrial policy, that is privatization was introduced and made popular, that is now that insurance business can be taken by the private people also. We can see Reliance, we have Bajaj Finance, we have different types of finance insurance companies has come forward with the help of this second feature, that is reduced the industries under the public sector. That is only very essential ones, strategic important companies are held with whom? The government. The rest of the things were privatized. Even you can see nowadays, even a part of railways is also privatized. That is a private company can also hold this particular type of business. Only left out thing is two, I hope, that is atomic energy and arms and ammunition. These two left with the government, public sector. Remaining almost everything is privatized. That is any person with good sound investment and knowledge technology, they can start a particular type of business in India. That is what your second point. Then disinvestment was initiated. Disinvestment means, I hope you know, that is taking back the investment from the equity capital. Earlier government has invested in that particular industry, now they are taking back the investment, means a part that they are giving to the private people. Private people can invest, government is taking back the funds. That has been introduced again through your 1991. Then policy towards foreign capital was liberalized. Here liberalization in the sense what? Lessening or loosening the rules and regulations, restrictions over the business from a particular country. So similarly, foreign capital, more restrictions were there on the foreign capital. Later on, what it was liberalized. That is, restrictions were lessened, loosened, or reduced. Then automatic permission was granted for technology agreement with foreign country. So it was made so easy to enter into collaboration or to enter into joint ventures with the foreign countries with the help of what? Same 1991 policy. Then Foreign Investment Promotion Board, that is FIPB, was set up to protect and channelize the channelize the foreign investment in India. So FIPB, this is the board set up by the government of India in order to protect and channelize foreign investment in India for the safety of the funds of the foreigners. Alright, so these are the features of your LPG, that is 1991 New Industrial Policy. So here we'll go with the word meaning, that is, what is liberalization, privatization, globalization, and we'll be studying only the features of liberalization. We'll be seeing only the meaning part of privatization and globalization. You know this because you have studied in economics, but also just for reference you can take this. Liberalization in the sense what? Loosening, making free, restrictions are reduced on the business. Simple. Privatization in the sense the ownership of business, the control of business is transferred from public sector to the private, that is from the government to the general public. Then globalization in the sense making entire world under a single roof, we say in general word, right? So now now entire world has become a village, we say, right? So it is integration or interaction among the people and companies and even government worldwide, making together, right? So this is a simple meaning of your liberalization, privatization and globalization. Okay, this can be asked for 1 or 2 marks. So through New Industrial Policy of 1991, these three were highlighted, that is LPG was emphasized. Now we'll see the features of liberalization. As I said, we are not going to study about our privatization and globalization. We'll be seeing the features. The features are like this. What is this liberalization? Abolishing of licensing. We have seen the same thing in policy 1991 features now. That is abolishing in the sense taking away, avoiding the licensing. So for many types of businesses, the licensing that was cancelled. Now freely you can start a business. Only you will be having a list of businesses which has to compulsory take the license. Only for that you have to take. Many businesses does not fall under this list now. Then providing freedom for expansion and contraction of business. So earlier, if you want to expand the business, if you want to reduce your size of business, is what's so difficult. So such a difficulties or tough procedures make people go forward. Okay, in order to avoid such things, in order to make a free flow of people into the business, such rules were introduced. That is one of the feature of your liberalization. Okay. Removal of restrictions on the movement of goods and services. Now goods can be easily moved from 1991 policy itself. It is easily they can move from the state to state, even country to country. Restrictions were reduced. To provide freedom in fixing the price of goods and services. Okay, even we know that we can fix a price for our product. Generally we'll be fixing on the basis of a competitor's price. Even we'll be having some of the guidelines from the government, but not major portion will be there with the particular industry itself. The such a freedom is given by the government through liberalization. Then to simplify the processes for imports and exports. So too many processes were involved in imports or exports. Actually we have seen this import processor and export processor. If you remember, export processor is too lengthy. Okay, so such restrictions, though they see they seems to be very lengthy procedure, it has been reduced to maximum extent. Okay. Next, reduction in tax rates. Even tax rates were reduced drastically. Now, even with the BJP government, we have come out with GST, that is single tax. Earlier, though they were reduced, many types of taxes were there. But now we have a single tax, that is an updation to your new industrial policy. Then comes free flow of foreign capital and foreign technology. So through liberalization, foreign capital will be easily moved into our country. If you remember, we have seen ADR and GDR, right? International money, how it will be flowed into our country. That also we have seen in our first year syllabus. So that was made very easy. So these are the features of liberalization, which can be asked for same 4 marks, or it can be for 2 marks. Any two features, they might ask for 2 marks. So we have to remember this. Next, we have demonetization. We know this demonetization because we are aware of that situation also. In recent 2016, 8th November, if I'm right. Okay, so our country has this demonetization, right? So they have put an official stop to a particular currency. So demonetization refers to what? It refers to putting an official stop to the country's particular currency and declaring that is banned. That is what your demonetization is. So this is not under your new policy of 1991, but just a topic is there. There we end actually the new policy, new industrial policy of 1991. This is only a topic added to particular concept, as it will also have effect on business and counts under economic environment of the country. So demonetization in the sense putting an official stop the country's particular currency and announcing that it is banned, it will be no more in the used in the country. Okay, what are the features? So why demonetization is done in general? We might have different idea, but theoretically we'll be having these 4 important features for the demonetization. Initially, for tax administration measure, your demonetization is used as one of the tax administration measure. Administration in the sense a macro level word for your managing. Okay, so in order to manage the taxes, demonetization is used as one of the measure, right? Then to say that no tax evasion, that is no one has to avoid paying taxes. Okay, in order to warn the country people, it has been introduced, that is demonetization, that is no longer tax evasion will be tolerated. Then cashless economy. In order to create cashless economy, this demonetization is used, and also to channelize the savings. See what happened when demonetization is made. Generally, the people, what the savings they have, they started deposit in the bank. They started going to the banks and they want to convert that old currency into the new currency. This is a situation where the government comes to know what money you have actually. So upon what they can have tax, they can. If not, that amount on which you have not paid tax will be turned into what? Black money. So black money is nothing but the money on which you didn't pay any tax. But because of this demonetization, what happens? Now the money what you have in a particular currency which is banned, that has to be taken to the government, that is to the bank, and there you have to exchange with the new currency, right? Then what happens? The amount of fund what you have will be known to the banks, and through banks it will be known to the government, and then it will be easy for the government to administrate tax and to create and to make you and to charge you tax and to collect the tax in a right manner. And it also helps the people to invest their money in the banks. So what happens when you deposit your money in the banks? The bank will use that funds for the right purpose. So you know the how bank will give loan to the general people. By accepting the deposit, they can render or they can lend loans. If you don't deposit money into the bank, and if you keep yourself, what happens? Generally, that money will not be available to the government for use. So because of all these things, demonetization has been introduced. And the last topic of this chapter, we have like, what is the impact of this government policy change on the business? See, they have come out with new policy and they have made some demonetization program also. So how it has affected or it has an impact on our business? That is what our main concept we are studying. How an economic environment will be having impact on us because of the economic environment. Okay, so because of this new policy, there is increased competition. Why? Because what happened through liberalization, privatization and globalization, new companies, that is international companies, have stepped into our country, and generally the demand for the different products will vary now, because many companies are there to supply and the demand will be generally less. Now there is will be a rate of competition generally high. Okay, so more demanding customers. Now customers, they have become they know many things, because now they compare everything. So the customers have become more intelligent, I can say. They have more awareness now, because when they compare the different products from the different, we really get products from the different country and we don't know from which country is, but we generally use in our day-to-day life. Colgate is one of the best example I can give, toothpaste. Okay, actually we don't know, or many don't know it is from which country, but it is a part of our daily life. Okay, now what I want to say is, because of this policies change or introduction of LPG, what happens, generally people has they got more awareness and they have become more demanding. Now they don't take what the company produce, the company has to produce what the customer need. That the situation has turned like this. That is what we say, more demanding customers. Then rapidly changing technology. As we know that we know the different stages of economic structure, economic environment. So we are almost in mass consumption stage. Okay, mass consumption, or we can say one more back step, that is your technological era. Okay, so now we have more technology, we need, we want to update ourselves with the more technology. Rapidly we have to change ourselves to adopt the new technology. Such a situation has been arised. If not, what happens? There will not be no customers for your particular product if you don't update yourself with the new technology. Then, and there is a necessity for change, because always customers need new things. They compare with many products, hence there is a need to change. So business always, that's what we say, business always exists in what? Dynamic environment. Need for developing human resources. So there is a complete need for developing the human resource of a particular country and the business, what they are using. Human resource in the sense manpower. Okay, that can be developed through what? Good training programs and all. Market orientation. Now it is no more sales oriented, it is market oriented. That is whatever consumers demand, that you have to produce, the companies has to produce and sell. And there is a loss of budgetary support to the public sector. As we know that government has taken back the investment from the government. Now many government companies, they have to earn their own money, like departmental undertaking, statutory and government companies, they have to work hard and they have to take the they have to earn the money through their businesses. Earlier what happened, government through their budgets they used to supply the funds, but now through the help, through the introduction of LPG and disinvestment, what happened, the government has taken back the investment, that is from equity, and even in many ways the investment was taken back, and now it is a compulsory situation for a public sector industries to compete with the private sectors. So in this way it has impact on our business. So here we end this particular chapter called business environment. So I want to have a quick recap. We have started with meaning of business environment, and then we have seen importance and features, right? Both are very important for 4 marks, meaning for 2 marks, and your features and importance for 4 marks. Okay, then comes your dimension. So we have 5 dimensions, like economic environment, social, political, legal, environment and social. Okay, so all those 5 environments you have to remember, and the chart is very important. at least for meaning that can be asked for 2 marks. And then we have concentrated on economic environment of a country. There we have seen what was our condition, what was India's economic environment at the time of independence. And even we have seen how LPG has been introduced, that is new industrial policy of 1991 that has been introduced. And that LPG, we have seen meaning of LPG, we have seen, and particularly we have studied the features of liberalization. Okay, then we have seen demonetization as a one more topic introduced in this concept, and features of demonetization which can be asked for 4 marks. And last you have impact of this policy change, that is introduction of new policies LPG on our business. This is 7 points. So this can be asked for same 8 marks. It can be, there is a chance. So go with that. The concept might be new to you, but also try to learn. And if you have any issues, please call me so that I can explain once again. Hope you do so. Till we meet in our next class. Take care. Bye.